Welcome you to the Seeing the Unseen exhibition, which happened in Chitrakala Parishad from the 29th to the 31st, and from 1st it is happening here at Honeycomb Gallery and will go on till the 9th of June. And the exhibition is called Seeing the Unseen. It's an exhibition of photographs on the invisible symptoms of multiple sclerosis. So here we are having a panel discussion on the photography for a social cause. And the panelists here are Mr. Shankar Subramanian.
Hello.
Mr. Pankaj Gupta. Mr. Girish Mayachari. Mr. Arun Bhatt. Mr. Shitidhar. And Mr. Arun Mohan. Hello. Let me just introduce you. Mr. Shankar Subramanian has been pursuing photography since 15 years. He is passionate about travel and portraiture, and he has won national and international photography awards. He was a student of Mr. Anand Sharan, a veteran photographer, and along with him he started a photography club called TGIS, thank God it's Saturday, which conducts photography exhibition every year for a social cause. And welcome Mr. Shankar.
Thank you, Sri Kumar.
Mr. Pankaj Gupta. Mr. Pankaj Gupta works for an offshoring company in Bangalore. He is a computer science graduate by chance and a shutterbug by choice. He is accredited by the Photography Society of America and has won many international awards. He is an MS warrior, and on top of that, he is also a certified scuba diver, marathoner, explorer, traveler, trekker, theater artist, etc., etc. Please welcome. Then we have Mr. Girish Mayachari. Girish is a freelance photographer. He is passionate about photography when he was a kid. He took his passion as a serious hobby, and once he started working, his works are exhibited in close to 15 countries, and he has achieved the distinction from the Master of Light Organization Canada. Please welcome him. We have Mr. Arun Bhatt. Arun Bhatt is an award-winning international acclaimed photographer, who is also a co-founder of Data Photography Club. Data Photography Clubs, they conduct photo tours, they conduct photography exhibitions, etc. Please welcome Arun. And then we have Shitidhar, who is a BCom graduate, and he is the youngest of the whole lot. Please welcome Shitidhar. And we have Mr. Arun Mohan. Arun Mohan is an MS person. He's a model for Mr. Shankar for some of the photographs which is displayed over here, and he is also a life coach and an MS warrior. Please welcome him. Now I'd like to start my questions with Mr. Shankar. Sir, could you just kindly share us a few words about the MS Day and its importance?
So, across the world, the 30th of May is considered as a, we observe it as a World MS Day. And this is to bring about awareness about multiple sclerosis. You see, in India, we are estimating that we have approximately 2 lakh 50,000 approximately number of MSPs. We were thinking that overall in the world, we might have around 2.5 million MSPs, but in the recent survey, United States alone has reported around 1 million MSPs. In fact, it's a very prevalent outside of India, but it in a 1.3 billion population, 200,000 people are quite a small population. So through the World MS Day, we hope to bring in awareness. We also would have this would help us in the advocacy efforts to bring in, highlight the some of the challenges that the MSPs face as far as their own financial burdens, their own medical burdens are concerned, and hope that through this, we can help them reduce the burden of the challenges that they are presently facing through the government schemes that are there. So, in fact, the exhibition was attended by the director for empowerment of disabled and senior citizens, who are one of the forums to come up with schemes that will help the MSPs, and they had come for the exhibition and they said that they will do their best in order for them to support with whatever government schemes are possible.
Roughly how many MS warriors you would be having in a city like Bangalore?
So we are expecting that they're again maybe having around 2,000 people maybe, but it's all a rough estimate. One of the challenges is that MSPs do not like to share that they have MS because they're afraid of the social stigma, and also they consult with private neurologists and doctors don't share this medical information or the patient information so readily. So it's very difficult for us to identify, and I hope that people who are watching the panel discussion live are able to contact the Multiple Sclerosis Society of India and register themselves so that we can have a bigger voice in the community.
Okay. And you conduct this exhibition every year and usually around this time. Is it because it is celebrated, you have the MS Day on?
So we thought that we should have something on the World MS Day, which is 30th of May. I know it's a very hot time and a warm time for all of us. But as it, in the other European countries and other places, it's a fairly nice time of the year. But India is not. So we have a separate India MS Day, which we observe in February, where more MSPs participate. But the World MS Day, we primarily use it as an awareness so that the rest of the world can get to know about MS and some of the challenges the MSPs face.
Thank you. And one more thing, what I would like to ask you is, could you just let us know about TGIS and how TGIS is connected with MSSI?
Sure. So, thank God Saturday is a club we formed 8 years back. It's an informal club. So, we meet on the weekends. So, because we meet on Saturdays or Sundays, we named it TGIS, which stands for Thank God It's Saturday. It's a very diverse group which has lawyers, doctors, IT professionals, businessmen as part of the group, and they get time on the weekends to practice photography. And as we started photography, we realized that we had such lovely pictures, we should exhibit it. So once we decided that we should exhibit it, of course, Honeycomb Art Gallery was partnering with us on the printing and helping us to put the images across. We said, why not we raise funds for a charity with that? So we've been, over the past 7 years, regularly we've been conducting these exhibitions to raise funds for Multiple Sclerosis Society of India. And we've been able to raise around anywhere between 7 to 9 lakhs per exhibition to support the MSPs through the exhibition.
Thank you, Mr. Shankar. Mr. Pankaj, I would like to ask, could you just share us, since you being an MS warrior, would like to share us a few words about multiple sclerosis and how, what are the challenges that you face generally?
Okay, so before I start, I want to just clarify what you just when you went through the introductions. I'm not sure about who's the youngest, Trichitar and me. I think I'm younger than him. Okay, so anyway, multiple sclerosis is something which is what I would call a very unknown kind of a disease or condition where we don't know what is the why it happens and what is the cure for it, right? Which is why it's kind of unique. The science has reached only reached Mars now, but we don't know how, what effects and why such a disease happens and what is the cure for it. So the only cure or the only medication which is there is to suppress it, to try to suppress the onset of the multiple sclerosis, right? So what basically happens is that multiple sclerosis, basically it is your nerves are getting eroded, like just like how an electrical wire will be eroded and the wire as such is exposed, right? And the signals coming from the brain or the nervous system is coming in patches. So which part of your body it affects, we don't know. Like every person is different, which is why it's a very unique kind of impact to every person. What happens to one person may not happen to the other person. The medication is very unique to each person, so that there's no one standard medication for all the MSPs. So you may have things like, you may get difficulty with balance issues, you may have vision problems, most of the symptoms are kind of also displayed in this exhibition as well. You may have
spasticity,
you may have memory problems, you may have speech problems, you may have, you might have difficulty mobility issues, you may have lose a limb, or you might have difficulty that. It's a very unknown kind of a mysterious kind of a condition, right? So there is some research happening on it, but because like Shankar said, the unfortunately, I'm using both words, the number is very less for the pharma companies to be interested in doing research, or too much more research, as it is for like diabetes or cancer, because there is money to be made there. You know, if you make some new medication, they know that there is, you know, billions of people or millions of people who can potentially buy their medicine. But in MS, 2.5 million across the world is what we know so far, which is not enough for somebody to spend millions on research, right? So which is why it is a fairly evolving kind of a disease condition. We hope someday that we'll get a cure for it, but not as yet, right? So, but which is why organizations like MSSI are very important to help the MSPs through their journey of MS, right? So it is, and I think, you know, having, now since you got this, asked this question, I think I have cracked the solution to life. And I haven't told you the solution yet. So I think, you know, I very strongly, I started believing for the last a year or so actually, is that, you know, every human or every person, the three main components are mind, body, and soul, as we think it is, right? So I feel that if all of us, whether we are an MSP or not, doesn't matter, if all of us do something every day which exercises your mind, something else, which exercises your body, and exercises your soul, right? I think they will live, we all will have a very, very happy, contented life. Nothing can happen to them. It'll be a very, MS, cancer, nothing can even affect them, is what I feel, right? Which is why I think, you know, art or photography specifically, comes into play. I started photography seriously after, you know, I got diagnosed with MS, is that, you know, and you know, my seniors can kind of guide me with that, right? But photography, I think, exercises all three. Mind, because you have to see what settings and what aperture speed, you know, shutter speed and aperture and ISO, what to use. There is a mental activity which is required for photography, right?
Yes.
For bodies, because you need to be mobile, you need to, you know, move around and, you know, take travel for taking photographs, and you need to be mobile. So the body also is kind of exercised to a bit. Soul is because it appeases to what you firmly like or firmly, you know, believe in. Right? Which is why I think it's also meditative, because you are, you know, photographers spend hours and hours in just one scene to see how they can take different angles and stuff like that.
Kind of a zen, right?
So it's very meditative, I think, as well. So back to my original point, I think if all of us do something which exercises your mind, body, and soul every day, if we can, be it formal meditation, or be it something like photography, or be it some exercise through like a running or some, you know, swimming or whatever it is, and something, my wife tells me that, you know, moving the channels on the remote, it is not considered as physical exercise. So that doesn't consider as a body activity. But anyway, so I think you know, MS is, it's a very, very new disease. Back to your original question, people don't know what the cure is and what the origin is. It's not hereditary, it's not contagious. So that's good for that, right? So, you know, just because I have it doesn't mean that my daughter would have it. There's no connection to that. And it's not contagious as well. So it's not that I have, you know, Shankar and Girish will have nothing like that, right? So I think it's still evolving. I mean, we still don't, it's a mystery as of now, but I think it's okay. I think we are getting there, right? Which is why, like I said, you know, things like this is very, very important. It's even more important because there's so much of support which is required for MSPs from the outside, because there's not much of support from the medical angle, right? So, you know, there is some support, but not a cure as such, which is why, you know, organizations like MSSI really have a very, very big role to play in MS.
Would you like to say something about MSSI itself, because you've spoken so much about MSSI? Like,
I think
what does MSSI do?
So MSSI does everything but prescribe medicines. Right? We don't prescribe medicines. We do have doctors on our panel, but we don't. We leave the prescription of medicines to the doctors, to the experts, because they know exactly what works and which part of the immune system needs to be, you know, addressed or suppressed. But what we do is we help the MSPs with everything else to, you know, to kind of build a life which is which they can live as a normal person, right? For example, we give, you know, we arrange for physiotherapy sessions, we arrange, we give, support them in some medicines as much as possible, financial support. We help them in providing, you know, having fun camps, like, you know, where they can take their mind off that they have MS, you know, be like a normal person. We arrange for medical camps where doctors, they can ask doctors their questions and what symptoms they are going through, what can, what does it mean, etc. Because MS also can be progressive. It can, you know, get worse and worse and worse as well. So it's very important for a constant connection of between the doctor and the patient, which is, and we kind of help, help support that, right? So we do everything but prescribe medicines to the MSP. So we try to take care of the other parts of our life as much as possible, apart from actually prescribing the medicines.
I think another thing is that what you're saying is that you create an ecosystem.
Correct.
Where, you know, different people like the government, the, you know, healthcare professionals.
Correct.
Everybody
yeah.
comes together
right.
and sees how we can make the quality of life
of
the MS person.
Correct. Yeah, the government, we have had a lot of good interaction with the government recently. You know, we have had MS being included as part of the Disability Act about a year and a half, 2 years back, which is great because government did not recognize MS as a condition, right? So now it's part of the Disability Act where MSPs can take avail of the benefits of from the government of, you know, being registering as a disabled person and taking the benefits from the Disability Act. So and we initiated that, right? So we spoke to the government and, you know, how we have a very strong connection with the Disability Commissioner and like Shankar mentioned, because he even came to kind of inaugurate the exhibition for us. So we have, I think ecosystem is probably the right word. We create an ecosystem where, you know, physiotherapists, the government, and the other people in the society can come together to make the life of the MSP a little bit better.
Thank you. Thank you so much for that, all the insights. Yeah. Now, being mentioned all these things, I would like to share a few words about how you feel about participating, being a model for Mr. Shankar and having your photos displayed in this kind of an exhibition.
Okay.
Yeah.
The first time when Shankar, I know Shankar for a year or so, and the first time Shankar asked me, can you be a model for me? I was like, I haven't taken one single photograph of myself for the last 20 years. When Shankar said, can you model for me? I was like, me? You're asking me about it? So I said, okay. And this is for a cause to make people understand what MS is all about. Because I was diagnosed around about 5 years back with MS. And the first time when I found out that I have MS, it was because of a watchman in a government hospital, institution. Where at 7 in the morning, the government, the watchman there told my mother-in-law, please ask him not to come inside because this fellow is drunk. That's the biggest problem what MSPs have. That what you go through, people do not understand that. People think that you're drunk. I used to slur a lot. So when you cannot walk straight and you start slurring, people say that you're drunk. And where without drinking, if somebody calls you as a drunkard, it's a very, very bad impact that you have on your life. That's how I started off 5 years back. That's when I finished my life coaching course also. And when I started life coaching, I became a life wellness coach. When I started doing that, I used to talk to more of the MSPs than the regular people to make them, because they need somebody to hear them out. They don't want a solution from anybody, but they want somebody to hear them out. And when you start listening to the problems that people have, you actually feel good about yourself, saying that, boss, you have nothing compared to what problems others have. And that's when I started getting motivated myself, saying that you're much better than a lot of other people. There are people who cannot move a limb out of that. They're completely bedridden for the last 10 years and takes a huge toll on people, saying that, wow, I'm not able to do anything. Like Pankaj was saying, multiple sclerosis became a part of the Disability Act. And it's very difficult for a person who has been active in life suddenly being called as disabled. Last year at the Delhi airport, when somebody said, do you have an ID card? I gave my disability card to show them. The moment I showed it to them, I had a wheelchair coming. They said, you sit down, you don't have to do anything. You just sit down and we'll do everything for you. I've only seen people on a wheelchair. Now, suddenly you finding yourself sitting on a wheelchair is very, very painful for the for me as a person. I felt very painful. But then the kind of love that I've got from people around is incredible. Incredible. Today, I'm talking about people sitting here itself. I have a couple of my relatives here also. They do not let me move my hand. That's it. They say, you tell us what we want, we will do it for you. That's the kind of response that people have been giving me. And when people, when as a person, you're not used to this kind of help, and suddenly everybody is like, oh, is it okay if you can walk? Is it possible for you to walk? It's really touching for most of us.
Do you feel anything, like, do you feel you've taken the positives, or do you feel, okay, now I was completely active and suddenly there is this thing which is affecting me? Do you get demotivated or something like
that? I'll tell you, I was into sales for around about 20 years, and I have never got this kind of this kind of attention from people for what I've done earlier. Never have I got. I've got a couple of awards, and today when Shankar shared the newspaper article of mine, my photograph was put across in the newspaper. I was like, I have never come across in a newspaper. And today my photo is coming on the newspaper because I have MS. So I should thank MS for, I am really thankful to God that finally somebody recognized me for what I have.
Do you take, like, other than like what, like Mr. Pankaj, he goes in for various activities like theater and trekking. Would you try something from to what you can do? There are certain limitations.
I do everything which is possible. You ask me to climb these stairs, maybe I'll faint at the end of the stairs, but then I will climb down. I will do as much as possible. So there's no question of you losing out and saying, oh, I can't do this. There's no point in doing that. Who is the loser? I am the loser. So why stop yourself? Maximum what will happen? It's like today people say you cannot walk. So why are you walking then? I fractured my leg last year 2 times, you know, in a year. So it's like I cannot stop myself from walking just because I fall down. You fall down, you get up, you start going about your back to your work.
Thank you so much for this talk. So now there is one thing. What is the most important message you would like to share about this whole event? What is happening? Which is going to happen?
This event. For me, if you ask me, it's like I said, till 5 years back when I got awards, people never knew that, okay, this fellow got an award, you came to the stage, took the award, went off. Today, people call me and say, oh, I seen you in the newspaper, your photograph is there. Oh, I came to that exhibition. And it's really, really touching. Because the most of the symptoms that are shown here is actually what I go through. Believe me, Shankar, when he took this, especially this photo where double vision is concerned, That's how I see people. Nobody understands that. For me, this, when I look at you, you're shaking for me right now. So now, I just imagine if I'm looking at a girl and suddenly the girl shakes. I'm like, is she shaking this side or she's shaking this side? So I'm staring at the girl and the girl starts saying, why are you staring at me? I'm trying to figure out where you're sitting. That's the issue. I'm trying to figure out whether he was sitting here or here. So this particular image touched me a lot because that's how I see people. That's how, for me, my vision is right now.
Thank you.
And my head keeps shaking, so I'm like trying to figure out. I hope I'm not putting into an embarrassed situation where they say you can't even sit straight properly. So today people understand that these are all the symptoms that we MSPs go through. So they are very helpful to me for that. So I guess an exhibition like this makes an incredible voice to make people understand what people like me go through. I'm sure Pankaj understands that because as an MSP, he has also gone through the same.
I mean, you seem to be like a real fighter.
Oh.
And also, what do you feel that MSSI has contributed? Have they contributed to your life betterment, of the vision of MSSI? Have they done?
Believe me, I never knew what MS is all about till I got MS. And that's when, you know, one, people go through the depression of they have been suffering like this. MSSI has done an incredible job till now. I come from Chennai, so I know what MSSI Chennai is all about. The moment Shankar called me and said, "Can you do this for us?" I said, "Why not?" And believe me, a lot of people in MSSI say, "Wow, this is what MSSI does for you." There are so many other people who are having a low life. They don't know who to express it. And MSSI does that job where you make people get together and make people understand that MS is not a death-defying disease or problem that they have. It's an incredible opportunity that you get, saying, you know, you can do much better than what you're going through from here.
Thank you. What we could gather. Now coming to Mr. Arun and Mr. Girish, I would like to ask you a common question, which is, both of you are internationally acclaimed photographers. Now I would like to ask you, like, how do you share your experience on conceptualizing the images, and how was the audience reaction to these images? I don't think it's
okay. I was hoping Girish will go first. Stop my name. I come from the same background that these guys mentioned about, that I was not very aware of MS. So if I had met Tarun maybe a couple of months ago, I would have been wondering what's happening here, why is he what he is, and I would have all those misconceptions that Tarun had come through. And when Shankar invited me to this exhibition and said, "Let's participate and work on this," the first thing that I had to do, or I got the opportunity to do, was to understand what is MS and figure out through reading about the symptoms and educate myself about what MS is. And subsequently, of course, my challenge was to visualize them in images or create images that would represent so many of the symptoms that MS has. I was a little of a slow starter in the sense that we were a group of six who started discussing about how to represent the images, and a few people started pouring in their images, especially Shankar himself. I think started with the first images of Arun that kept me questioning what should I do and how should I try to represent the symptoms of MS. Some of us started doing a lot of portraits and images in the outdoors that represent symptoms like depression or other problems that MS people would have. And I realized that most of us would be working on portraits of people trying to express their emotions as an MS person, such as, say, double vision or depression or some of the other symptoms of MS. Then I realized that while a lot of our talented photographers are trying to help portray those emotions from the faces of people, when I have people trying to act the symptoms of MS, there will be some limitations in the other person, the person who is trying to show the symptoms of MS through his action. So I decided perhaps I'll take a different approach and see how else can I represent symptoms of MS, mostly perhaps abstract, not necessarily human emotions shown through human faces. Then I thought about other possibilities, perhaps use some colors or use some shapes or use some other abstractions that could possibly denote symptoms of illness. And then that's when I try to connect some of my past work to what MS people suffer from. So for example, I have a vast collection of landscape images from several trips that I do across the world to several places that are like in the high mountains or in the deserts and all that. And I realized that some of these places in the nature can actually help me represent the symptoms of MS very well. Say for example, MS persons are very sensitive to hot and cold temperatures. So they might find it difficult to touch ice or something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong in telling the symptoms. So this could easily be represented through some icy landscapes that I've been to. And there are other things like, say for example, pain that you suffer as an MS person when you touch something. And I tried to represent that through pointed mountain peaks that I had some pictures of. So what I did was, instead of trying to get people to enact the symptoms of MS, which sometimes can be limiting, and also for the fact that a lot of us, a lot of others in the group were also doing the same thing and it could be repetitive a little to some extent, I decided that I'll take this approach where I'll choose some landscape images and perhaps alter them if required to emphasize the symptoms of MS. And eventually came out with pictures of a variety of landscapes and those landscapes representing in an abstract way the symptoms of MS. So the pictures are here, of course, people who are looking through the YouTube may not be able to see it, but all of you who are here would be able to see those landscape images. And perhaps you could even try to see if you can identify some of the MS symptoms from those landscape images. So that was my approach to making these images.
And Girish, here most of your images are color images.
Yeah.
And you have almost 75% of them black and white.
Right.
So what was that made you make all of them in color?
Okay. So to say, I'm a fan of colors. So not that I don't do monochrome images. I do love doing that. But for me, colors definitely play a big role in whatever I shoot. At the same time, when I started visualizing or conceptualizing about this whole shoot, I knew I wanted to bring in a dark element to it. You know, I wanted the images to actually highlight the symptoms rather than anything else in the image. So abstraction in terms of making it a monochrome image also would have worked, but here I didn't want to do that because the colors also have their own words, you know, they speak a lot. So I wanted to make use of those colors also, but have a dark background or a dark feel to the image that would actually make the person viewing the image more attracted to what the image is trying to say. So for me, the important thing was to make the images convey what I wanted to say. So that's where I used the vibrant colors as much as possible.
Okay, and so what was the people's response? Like it happened in CKP, like how, what was the audience response to this?
I think the audience response was to me quite surprising because their ability to connect immediately was something that in one way I had achieved my objective, but I wasn't expecting that level of appreciation or that level of connectivity from the viewers. So the viewers who had come, the audience would come, they were all like, look, this is fantastic, this is lovely. So not only in terms of understanding what the image was trying to say, but they also were appreciative of the way it had been shot. So I mean, in fact, one of the best compliments I got was from Arun here, when he said, I like the way you have used light across the images, it has come out really well. So that kind of feedback was really, it gave me a high, I can say.
So why don't you throw in some more light about it? What made you decide to use lights?
Yeah, as I said, when I started conceptualizing, one of the main things that I wanted to do was bring a dark theme to it. Because we were trying to speak about something which people were not aware, and these were symptoms which were invisible. So the first challenge was how do you show something that is not seen? So it was a combination of things that you know, drove me towards visualizing the images in a particular way. And once I started visualizing it, it was a question of how do I execute that? And that's where I decided to use a speed light to create that effect of, you know, darkness at the same time capturing the details that are very critical. So that's how I
went
about it.
In fact, the image which you have of the ants going on the,
yes,
on the arms,
right?
I think that's very much the feel of how an MS person feels like at some point of,
yes,
time, as if the ants are crawling all over, you know, that kind of a thing. And it's very, that image was kind of quite strong image which was connected to the audience.
Yeah, I mean, that image, again, I think I took inspiration for that image from another image that was available on the net. Somebody else shot a similar image. That's where I, you know, worked on that image and said. In fact, one of the questions that the audience would come ask me was, the ants are there on the hand, but we don't see the reflection of it on the table. And I, for me, the reason I did not put the reflection on the table, you know, because it's not real. The ant's not real. It's a feeling. So
right.
I was trying to convey that it's seen or it's felt, but it's not real.
Yeah.
If the ants were real, you would have had the reflection.
Yes.
No?
Correct.
So that
the name says it, seeing the unseen.
Yes. So that's exactly where I, you know, approached.
I watched a similar video on invisible symptoms, and
yes,
in that there was this whole thing about as if you feel ants
crawling
on you. So after I saw your image, I saw this video and I said, hey, that was fantastic that Girish was able to capture that. As
thank you. Yeah, in fact, that video was one of the you know, inspirations for me when I was conceptualizing for this entire shoot.
Arun, what about your landscape images? Like, I know it was a little cryptic for people to interpret, but how was your you know, the audience reaction to those images?
So one of the things that I was hoping for when I decided to put landscape images representative of symptoms is to get people to pause and think, because when you quickly pass by whatever you have seen, you might tend to forget. But these were not very evident symptoms that you could really see. So I wanted people to stop by and try to understand what would this image possibly represent, and what's the symptom that this picture may be talking about. And the response that I got from a lot of people is that they did have to work harder on finding out what the symptoms are. And they were very appreciative of that fact. And a lot of people also told me that this is one of the very creative ways that they have seen how the symptoms have been represented. And at the same time, a lot of people also were happy that they had to work towards identifying the symptoms.
Yeah, so the way we had done in the exhibition is we have this sheet of paper with 10 of these images, and with the list of symptoms. So people who came to the exhibition had to go around trying to figure out what these symptoms represent. So everybody had to, you know, stop, look, interpret, and spend some time. You know, if we did not have that engagement, people who are just, you know, if you don't have the connection, people just, they'll just go around saying, hey, you know, what does it say? So if you notice, we don't have any descriptions of with these things, because we want the audience to actually stop by, think, and interpret. Yeah.
Okay. 9 out of 10 people had a question that was that firecrackers.
Right.
Okay. Now,
coming to Shitida.
He's one of our youngest.
Yeah, as because I'm one of our youngest.
How do you share your views about your experience participating in this exhibition?
So the first time I got to know Shankar sir was through my father. So he had been for a conference, I guess. So that is how I got to know Shankar sir. So later on, like I used to send him my pictures whenever I used to go and shoot pictures, I would send him. So to get some views how he feels about these pictures. So once I just shot this image, so that is where he saw this image and said, okay, would you like to work on a project? You are going to be sharing the place with one of the best photographers, award-winning photographers. I was like, okay, sir, I would give a try for that. And later on, he's my friend called Bharat. So I asked him, see, this is a disease. So would you want to do it or should I check with someone? He's like, for you, come on, bro, let us do it. What's there in that? So I have to thank him as well for accepting it. So we just shot it in around 1 hour, I guess. That's what we do. So I had been given the symptoms before. So I just told him to try to give some expressions. So how we could show these symptoms. We don't know what they feel actually, but yeah, that is how we did it. So later on, it was like we had some discussions, we had some meetings, we used to go sit and used to check what could this symptom be. We used to question ourselves and that is how it was. And it was an amazing experience, I have to tell. So I would like to help, like this would be my small part of help, I guess, to make people understand this.
Yeah,
in fact, one of his images where you represents dizziness, he actually was lying on the ground and looking up, so that's how somebody would really.
Yeah.
So actually, through the lens of a person who has MS, if you were to see up and see the whole world circling, you know, it's a very simple image but very strong and powerful image. That's
And about who is the youngest person, I would like to see you guys settling it outside.
Right.
Now, just one question, one more question to you, Mr. Shankar. How can photographers help these kind of, maybe this is a condition and then you have autism, you have different, how can photographers help or how can they be used, like, I mean, for this, for a social cause, how can they help?
I think historically, I think they say a picture speaks 1,000 words, and we have seen in the past that many images have evoked just not the community but the entire world's empathy towards a cause. I think what I can recollect is Steve McCurry's "They Have Come," how that one image was such a powerful image, which is still in people's mind. That brought about so much of support to the Afghan refugee crisis, and people from across the world contributed the wealth to support that particular cause. Another one from the recent term, what I could remember, is that child, immigrant lying on, remember that?
The vulture at the back?
No, that was in Africa. But the recent one with the, I think it is Greece or some the place where the immigrants come, and there's young baby which is there. Very powerful image, and I think that really struck people's chord about the immigrant crisis which is happening in Syria and other places, how they're coming by boat and what they are going through, and that one powerful image. So I think everybody can bring about, now that we have social media, we have Instagram, we have Facebook, we have Twitter, I think photography can be a very powerful medium to highlight a cause that you are passionate with, and it can be a ticket to another level. So I think Arun could also share some thoughts on that.
I would just ride on what you already said, Shankar, that the power of stories is something that can really change the world, and photographs by themselves have, like you said, they have 1,000x power than what a word can probably do. So once you're able to portray some important aspects, whether it's about diseases like autism or world event or whatsoever, if you're able to create moving images that can tell those stories, lot more people will become aware of what's happening around them and will be able to appreciate them. So photography is a very important tool and an essential tool in telling your stories and telling the world about what's happening and what they should be knowing, and is certainly one of the mediums that we should all explore and make much use of.
Because I think like recently there was this Rohingya crisis, and there was an image from one of the Bangladeshi photographers who had captured one very touching moment there. And I think anybody who sees that image will really feel what's happening with the human society. What are we doing, and why are we in peace with each other? So I really feel that photography is a very powerful tool. And if somebody is really want to do something about a particular cause, I think it can be a very, very powerful tool.
Thank you.
And Girish says heat sensitivity. So this also created a very powerful impact. So many people, I heard many people that wanted to see this image. Yeah, I came for that. So
yeah, I think that's been across the newspapers.
Viral.
Yeah,
it's
the
most
viral
of
social media.
A lot of newspapers have used that image. Yeah.
And also just to add to what Shankar and Haruna said, you know, from a different perspective, I think, you know, photography and, you know, anybody who's done photography would know that the way we kind of compose a shot, an image, is that we try to focus on what is important.
Yes.
And then remove the distraction, remove the thing, which is how we should all live life, right? I mean, that's
correct.
Basically how
yeah.
we should live life. Focus on what is important and remove the noise, remove the distractions and stuff like that. So I think that way also, I think photography gives a very powerful message. I mean, to photographers as well, you know, how one should lead life. Thank you.
Any more points which you would like to share?
Maybe we can all have a closing comment.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry.
I think for me, this photography exhibition touched me a lot. And being honest here, people who came and told me these photographs are awesome, it's like these are things that I go through and it's been portrayed on picture. So I see myself saying, wow, this is something that I go through. And like Girish's picture, the fire and ice, I might start sweating. It's nice and cool out here. I'll start sweating. And for me, this is exactly what I go through. So for me, most of these, I wouldn't say most of them, all these photographs are things which I go through personally on a daily basis. So for me, it touched me a lot saying that where people get to understand what I am going through. I am not drunk. So people call me, you must be drunk to be behaving like that. I'm like, that's how I am right now. So there's no point in, you know, the moment people talk about all these things are what I go through, people, the first reaction, are you Paul? I don't want that sympathy from anybody. I'm just a normal human being. And MSSA is doing such a wonderful job saying that we won't be sympathetic towards you. We'll make you do stuff that you like to be doing. And that's the helpful thing that MSSA is doing. I should thank MSSA. Thank you.
Shanti,
that
any
closing
words?
Comments?
Yeah,
closing comments.
I couldn't tell anything. I should tell thank you to Shankar sir for giving me this opportunity. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome. You've done a great job.
Thank you so much.
Arun, do you like to?
Yes, most importantly, participating in this exhibition is an education for myself. And I do hope that being part of this exhibition, coming here and viewing, has been an education for all of you who have come here to be part of this exhibition, to see the exhibition, or to be part of this discussion. So that's my wish. And I hope that's the outcome of this exhibition. Thank you.
Okay. Shankar said, we from TGIS group, we have been organizing these exhibitions every year for the past 6 years. So I have been a part of all these exhibitions. Shooting for those exhibitions was different. Shooting for this particular exhibition, which was like a conceptual thing, was a completely different experience and a beautiful challenge that I've gone through. And I have been interacting with MS people throughout this time. And, Arun made a very beautiful point there. He said, we don't want sympathy. I think we all as human beings need to understand that we need to interact with others as human beings, period. Nothing more, nothing less. Let's interact with everybody as human beings. And that's the request I would like to make everybody.
Yeah, Beth. And in Greece especially, you know, I had a lot of personal challenges and stuff like that. In spite of that, he took time and, engaged with this. So I know what, effort you have put into this. Fantastic, Greece.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. I think my experience with the exhibition, I think, when we went to this exhibition was a first time I'm doing something which is theme-based kind of a shoot, right? So I was just thinking about how I can show the symptoms. And for example, the showing balance or issues with the physical balance. You know, my friend Tanya calls it corny. But that is something different to show, right? It's not to show physical balance. The person on Instagram has somewhere there. So to show that they can balance issues. You know,
I think the better one was the
tired.
to show. I mean, some of you didn't get it. I think most of you haven't got it. The car tire shows tire. So that's the name of the picture is TYRED. Tire. So anyway, so it is a very interesting experience for me. I think, you know, my only message, I guess, would be, give a message, but my only thought is that all of us, whether MS or not, doesn't matter, and it's very important to have something which is you're very passionate about, be it photography, painting, dancing, singing, anything, and not just your job which kind of feeds you, but also it's very important for us, all of us, to have that lovely distraction in life which you're so passionate about, and I think that is a solution to all, if not most, of our problems.
From my side, I'd like to, take this opportunity to thank Honeycomb. I think without their support and help, I would have found it very difficult. When I spoke to Nofil, your chief, and requested him to support us, he was very generous in saying that he's willing to sponsor the entire prints and the whole thing. So really very good. Rotary came forward for the, helping us to framing, and Solo Fees Enzyme, UbiCare, and also Esai Pharmaceuticals. They helped us to put up this exhibition. So I thank all the sponsors without whom this would not have been possible. And of course, everybody who came to the exhibition, in spite of being a weekday, and then today is a Sunday, we still have all the friends and family coming over here. So really making an effort to help us. So, and of course, our MSSI team, who's been working for the last couple of months to make this happen on a daily basis, and really put in a lot of effort. And of course, your Honeycomb team, which has really been a great support to have this up and about, and you being generous enough to give us your gallery to exhibit these pictures. So I really thank everybody who's been part of this exhibition to make it happen. And that's where, if we don't have the support of people in the society, we can't really get this correct. So thank you very much.
Before concluding, I would like to tell, I'm Shri Kumar, I represent Honeycomb. And we, not only for this exhibition, from past about 8 years, we started our company, Honeycomb Creative Support, in the year 2008. We started off as a retouching agency. Now we take care of graphic design, video production, web design. And one of our verticals is into fine art printing, where we help photographers print their images and exhibit in various art galleries and exhibitions. And we have been partnering with various photography clubs, like one like TGIS, for a social cause, be it MSSI or be it Rotary for Autism. So we help photographers on that front. And thank you all for coming and sharing your insights on this.
Thank you for all the audience for being here.